Hey y'all together and very welcome to the StarCraft 2 Crazy Replay today on Belshire Vestige, I have no freaking idea how to pronounce it, Leather Edition, White Edition. And as you might already hear, I'm a little bit hyped, don't know why, but that's the case. And I need to start and hurry up with the introduction because something is happening already in the top left hand side, in the red, as Protoss, Resellia. Playing against me, the bottom right hand side, the blue Terran for Pro Kings, Alex Usher. Woo, because this guy, Pylon, Gas, Probe, Whoop, 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 very strange build. And I can tell you, this game is strange, holy moly. Pepperoni. Ah, Gas, whoa, he wanted to Gas block, but I was able to block him out here for the time being. This is so important. I don't know why pros don't do this, because it screws up your build order so heavily, especially if you go for a one base build, which he currently looks like is doing, and you don't have double gas, so you can't go for Liberator and tanks, for example, you can't go for Raven if you want to. It limits you to one gas only, which means you need a lot of marines and bunker and turrets to defend, which makes you very immobile, and he behind can go for any tech he wants. And as you can see, this probe is super annoying, blocking not only one but two SCVs. I could ignore this probe, but if I do this, this probe will start tickling away my SCV building the barracks, which is bad already as well. And so far I'm doing a good job at keeping the Wisping Geyser safe. And looks like I'm going for command center right here right now, but he's going for double gas before cybernetics core. And this definitely has to be some kind of one base push, attack, all in whatsoever. Reapers on the way, reactors on the way. I might wanna scout for, oops, for the probe. I'm not sure if this Reaper will find the probe. Let's see. It could happen. That would be nice. Oh, it's looking very good. Look at that. Oh, oh, oh. So I will find the pylon and the probe, which means I can kill the probe. And no building drop because of the lack of minerals. There's one scouting SCV just for the case, so that I can scout if there's a nexus coming up or not. Hide it. You could hide it on the third or fourth base as well. It's not too bad. And behind that, robotic. Okay, robotics facility, second gateway, another pylon. I should kill this pylon, but the Reaper is busy scouting for other proxy locations, which could be the case, you never know. Oh! The probe! Woohoo! That was a little bit close. Not super close, but still could have gone either way, depending on which path the probe would have taken. I guess we'll produce another pylon. Adept is coming up. And behind that, oh, look at that. I scouted one base so far, so I bunker myself in. And interesting, very interesting. Though the Reaper can scout. Oh no! Oh no! The Reaper might kill the sentry. Ah! Yeah. Normally I would think the sentry wins. It has higher attack speeds, a little bit less damage, but losing the sentry to a Reaper is so annoying. There's one observer, Robotics Bay, right here. So Coloss or Disruptor could be the case here. I highly doubt that will be for observer speed. You know, could be, but very unlikely. And Resellia is doing quite something nice here. Oh, the Reaper might get a jump in here. Do I see it? That's a big question. No, I completely get shut down there. So I don't know what's going on, but I bunkered him myself heavily. He's still on one base. At some point he needs to attack. Viking on the Veil, just in case of War Prism, of course. You never know. But so far it's looking good for me, I would say. Yeah. Well, this still can go either way. You know, Protoss has some really strong units. And one lucky disruptor shot could kill me immediately. Looks like the adepts are coming in. Might wanna snag some SCVs, and I should get quite some. Or maybe not. Shade, shade, shade. No shade used here. And there's the tank. So you can will you get another SV there? Probably.
Yeah.
So now this orbital command is lifted. Adapt killing this one SCV. Get some, loses some points on the shields. There's the sentry. Another proxy pylon. Interesting proxy locations for all those pylons. There comes the disruptor. Yeah, you see there I'm hiding my SCV. Tanks on the high ground. Scan killing the ops, which is very important against this build. If he doesn't know where your army is, it's really hard for him to land those disruptor shots, but he might just do it. Either way, 6 kills here, that was half my marine count. And ouch! Definitely hurting. He's expanding right here on my potential 5th or 4th base, depending on what I would go for. But still, it's looking okay for me. I can do this. I have 3 tanks, and tanks deal 70 damage to armored units. Ah, disruptor gets 2 more kills. Disruptor is armored, so that's that. At some point, I should maybe be a little bit more aggressive with my push out. With the tanks, you know, siege up down there. But also I need to make sure that the tanks are covered by another tank. All the time. Stargate follow up. This could be really difficult for me to break. Sadly, Seeker Missile costs 125 energy now, otherwise I would be able to maybe get 2 Seeker Missiles on the Disruptor and kill them, but currently that's not the case. A little bit of scouting here. I might want to try to get the Observer, but it's unlikely with the Sentry and the Stalker. So 4 tanks in total now, up to 5 tanks, okay, and 4 barracks. Where's the 5th one? It's missing currently. Double Stargate follow-up. Autotour is doing their job. Disruption shots not connecting too good here. Oh, but I should... yeah, retreat back to the tanks. Where's the rest of my tanks? Oh, there's one. Okay, this tank is not in a bad spot. I would love to have it here. And covered by a tank here. Maybe one tank here. Or here. Here is also really good. If he doesn't have an observer, but he has one. And Resilia is taking up. Going for more Disruptor and Void Rays now, which definitely can work. Disruption Sphere. Not hitting. Or Nova. Purification Nova. That's the name. But I'm going for a third base. So overall, I would say I'm in a good spot. I need to get my tech up and running. I'm lacking supply depots. This is bad. I need a 5th barracks. Still. But I think I can still win this game here on Belshire Vestige, so... One Widowmine drop right here, BAM! That would be so awesome. But I'm not doing it, I'm still going for tanks. And tanks are not that bad. They are quite good. Sadly, I never scouted for any hidden bases, and the fact that he did retreat should tell me, wait a second, he needs to expand, because look at his main, it's dry, quite dry. But it looks like I'm moving up. Oh, that's... So... okay, does he know that I'm moving out, or is he just assuming it? I don't know. So he's poking in right now. I'm moving across the map. But, oh, there's a turret! The tank gets killed! And the Void Rays, bad focus fire, but it's... oh, nice! Both Void Rays die. Ah! Purification Nova doesn't connect, another turret won't be repaired here. This tank shelling away a lot of damage here. Onto those adapts. It looks like I might be able to hold this if it continues. Purification Nova again hitting hard. Now I'm into his main base, which is quite okay. He kills this tank now. Without this Void Ray I could have held, but now it's looking quite difficult. The next tank might get taken out. Big attack force, no medivacs with this army, every stim hurts, no combat shields as well. Combat shield will finish soon. Oh, that's not looking good. The medivacs boosting away. I think I lost one orbital command so far. Maybe not. No, not so far. The marines, can they do it? It's so close. No, they cannot. This disruptor might get killed here. Oh! This marauder, a real hero, but now with the double Stargate, more and more Void Rays are coming. I don't have any minerals left to produce stuff against the Void Rays. I do have enough marines, probably, to take those Void Rays out, but... yeah, I need the medivacs to counter-heal the Stim. And so far... there's only one medivac, so that's not a lot. And he still has mining, he's a little bit supply cap, but he can produce more stuff if he wants to. He lost the cybernetics core, the main is completely killed. But now I need to search first where to strike. He's killing more and more of my production, some SCVs survive. He's opting to kill. Oh no, the medivac! Ooh! That's so close! Six Void Rays, and they have quite some power. They are also as fast as the Viking. Well, not quite, but they are really fast. Losing some units there. Did I find his base? Yeah, I found his base somehow. In the meantime, look at all those icons here on the minimap. So many attack icons. So he's striking. And oh, the auto turret, he didn't kill my eBay. I have enough minerals for the missile turret, I mean. Oh, the photon overchargers are helping out a lot. I shouldn't lose all those marines here. Oh, the Raven, three auto turrets, no, just two. The missile turret just completing now, dishing out some additional damage as well. Is it enough? It looks like barely I can hold, but I lost a lot to those pylons. Six kills here, one kill there. Yeah, it's quite some units lost, and he still has some units left. In overall, he's quite far ahead. Look at that, in terms of supply. But is it enough? The Immortal is coming in, kills one tank. Will he get the second tank? Oh, bad focus fire, and both tanks survive. And five marines are enough to kill one Void Ray. There's one mothership core left. He finally can get the gateway, but he also can just only go for Zealots. Another Stim, that was bad decision making here. He might lose this Void Ray. Oh, that's good. There's one Void Ray left and one Stalker. Ah, one Photon Overcharge. Not enough. This single Stalker might wanna... oh, there's the Void Ray. This Void Ray is so important for him. The turret not in range. Oh, nice divide and conquer strategy out of him. Oh, the marines! The marines! One little marine left. This Void Ray, 19 kills. This marine solo! Ooh! Oh! One more shot! He gets it! 2 HP marine hero! And that's it. He can warp in one Zealot, but... I think that's game. Now I'm back to mining. I get some marines out, additional barracks. This hero marine saved the day, and there we go, GG! So that's it for today, thank you so much for watching, hope you enjoyed. As always, I wish you a very nice day and goodbye! Hey there, thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any wishes, feedback or suggestions, put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care. Bye-bye. Thank you.